Welcome back, everybody. You made it to the very last lesson of the Learn More JavaScript on the ServiceNow platform series. This last lesson, we're going to be talking about GlideQuery. GlideQuery is a modern way to query your ServiceNow database. GlideRecord is our older version, but GlideQuery is a newer addition to the platform, and it offers a more readable and a more maintainable way to handle those kind of database operations. GlideQuery is designed to make your server-side scripting cleaner, more efficient, and it's built on top of GlideRecord. But it provides a much more fluent API for querying tables, which makes your code easier to read and to understand and to write, actually. So let's go ahead and jump right in, and then we'll kind of make it a little bit more complex every time we run through these GlideQuery queries. So some basic usage. If you want to start a GlideQuery, we're going to say new GlideQuery. And we're going to say what table that we want to run it on. And then we're going to add a method on each line to keep it readable. But every method that we add, we'll just add a dot and then what we're doing on each one. And I'll show you what I mean. So on this incident, GlideQuery, I want it to be where all of our active is true. So only active incidents. And I'm going to add another parameter. I'm going to say where the priority is, let's say one, high priority. And then we're going to say what fields do we want to use in this script entirely. So this is one of the things that is different than our simple glide record. We're actually explicitly saying which fields we want to be using in the script so that it saves time, that it makes it run faster, and it's much more obvious when we're writing it what fields that we want to actually be utilizing. And so from there, I'm going to say for each record that you find, we're going to run this piece of code. We're going to say info, and we're going to say this incident plus the incident number. And so this part right here, incident, is coming from this parameter, which is being populated by the glide query itself. So each record that it finds is being placed into this incident variable. So incident.number, and I could have named it anything I wanted, but I named it incident to make it, you know, easier to read. The incident number, because I did ask for it, and I'm gonna say colon, and then incident short description. So pretty straightforward script, and then I'm going to go ahead and close this off. So make sure you match all of your brackets and stuff. So that one matches to this one, and then this one matches to that one, and we're done. All right, and this ends the entire GlideQuery. Notice that this is all one statement. This could have all been on one line, but to make it readable, we can put on new lines for each method that we're calling. So let me run the script. Oh, it worked first try. Yay, I typed it correctly my first try. So I usually use a better script editor for this, so typing it in plain text was an adventure. But here it is. For every incident, I could probably have added a space there, but it's working as intended. Here's all of my active high priority incidents and their incident number and their short description. So some basic usage of GlideQuery. Okay. Let's spice it up a little bit. Let's make it a little bit more challenging. So just like in GlideRecord, we can make our parameters a little bit more complex. So this filter where priority is one, we can actually say when priority is greater than two, for instance. Next, we can also say we want to order the list of records by sys-created on, so by the creation date. We can also say we only want 10. Don't give us any more than 10. We can also change up what fields we want to work with. And then in our for each, we're going to fix that space that we did earlier, put that space in there. And then we're going to change it to sys-created on here because we're not using short description anymore. Let's say was created on the created date. All right, let's run it. There you go. So incident was created on 2015-11-2, and you'll notice that it is in order because we ordered it. And is this 10? Yep, 10. So we were able to order it by the date, and we were able to limit it to just 10 records. And if we go and drill in to see what the priority was for each of these, they should all be greater than 2. Perfect. All right. So let's go back a little bit. Let's say we want to do updates via GlideQuery. So the syntax for updating is very similar. So this time I'm going to go ahead and store my GlideQuery in a variable this time, which is a standard practice. So new GlideQuery on sysuser, and where active is false. So we want to grab all of our active users, and we'll say for this example, if their last name is Duquesne. And then we're going to say update multiple. And so this is the syntax that you want to use if you want to update records using GlideQuery. And then inside of it, we want to give it an object of parameters. So here's our object. And we want to say, turn all of those records back on. Active is true. So if we were to run this, I didn't print anything, but it did run. No errors have popped up. So if there was any user on the table that was not active and their last name was Duque, then now they're active again. So that's the syntax that you want to use for that. Similarly, to add new records, we're going to say, we'll call this variable Fred, and we're going to say new glide query on the sys user table. And then we're going to say dot insert. Similarly, to update multiple, we're going to give it a object of parameters. So first name is Fred. And we'll say the last name is Luddy, our founder of ServiceNow. And so these variables right here, first name and last name, they match fields that exist on sysuser. So that means, hey, I want to create a new record on the sysuser table, and the first name field should be set to Fred, and the last name field should be set to Luddy. And so if I were to run this, it would insert it. But what if I want to keep working on this object, on this glide query, start updating more fields on it and stuff like that? We can say at the very end, get. And so what that means is go ahead and create the record, but then store that record inside of my Fred variable. And then now I can work on it further. So if I run the script, you'll actually see that that insert of that new record has happened. And if I go to my user table, there's a new record called Fred Luddy. There you go. My new user is Fred Luddy. And it's probably a good idea that I did dot get at the end, because there's a lot of other fields that I need to update here for it to be a good record. And there you go. That's how you do update or insert using GlideQuery. Cool. There's one more exercise yet before we end, but we'll see you on the next one.